Good morning, church. Happy Wednesday, April 8th, in our journey along Holy Week. And I wanted to come to you with a daily devotion from the daily readings that our church is going through. You can find a link to where to find those daily readings down below in the description of this video. And I do want to take a moment to encourage you to get involved with a daily reading schedule and even daily prayer. To find out and to continue to be in touch with God's will for your life so that you are interceding for the saints, you are hearing His will. As Scripture says, you are being washed in the Word, something that we want to be daily. So the reading today we're going to look at comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verses 1 to 5. And in this section, Paul begins to address an offering that he's been collecting from the different churches to distribute during a time of hardship that has come upon the church. So if you want to read along with me, 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verses 1 to 5 says, "We want you to know, brothers and sisters, about the grace of God that was given to the churches of Macedonia. During a severe trial brought about by affliction, their abundant joy and their extreme poverty overflowed in a wealth of generosity on their part. I can testify that, according to their ability and even beyond their ability, of their own accord, they begged us earnestly for the privilege of sharing in the ministry of the saints. And not just as we had hoped, instead, they gave themselves first to the Lord and then to us by God's will." Now, this daily devotion is not asking for money, nor is it part of some kind of funding drive for the church, but rather, I wanted to highlight that this set of churches, Paul says, out of your extreme poverty, you gave abundantly, even more than you were able to, for the sake of the churches. And then Paul was telling the Corinthian church this because he says, "I want you to be able to share in that joy and in that process with the Macedonian church, so get ready." The heart attitude behind all of this is that we are always to pour ourselves out upon the world. And it's not the great riches that are within us that God is often wanting. He like this Macedonian church, Paul says, out of your extreme poverty, you can give. And that gives us courage and encouragement because sometimes we think that we don't have a lot financially, talent-wise, time-wise. But that's never the point. God, throughout all of his work, uses those who seem to have the least. I think about Gideon hiding down in the wine press, threshing his wheat. But the angel comes and calls him a mighty man of valor and uses him for his purposes in a mighty way. Moses, the stutterer, so afraid and so worried, God used as one of the most amazing men in all of Scripture. So, what are you doing? How are you going to, through your extreme poverty, give out into this world in this time of crisis? There's critical need going on all around us. All we need to do is stop and look and see how is it that God wants us to use our lives now. So my daily encouragement to you, church family, read your scripture, pray, and as Henry Blackaby encourages in Experiencing God, look around you and see where God is working and then join him there. Pour yourself out upon this world even more than you think that you can, because God will supply what is lacking. May you be blessed today as you go about God's work, and may your ministry bear an abundant fruit.